Hey folks, how's it going? This week was British Pie Week here, which is admittedly a thing that was invented by a pastry company for marketing reasons, but I'm never one to pass up a good excuse to make a pie, so here we are. We're making a delicious chicken, leek and cider pot pie with a puff pastry lid. You can have this on the table in about an hour, folks, so let's get into it. We'll start by getting our veg prepped today, and for that I'll grab a medium-sized brown onion, which I'll cut in half, peel off the outer layers, and then roughly chop into smallish dice using my usual method. Next, I'll grab a couple of leeks. These are quite different in size, but we'll chop them down, so no matter. Before I do that, I'll just slice them lengthways into four pieces and give them a good rinse under cold water to get rid of any grit that's hiding between the layers. That done, I'll bring them back to the board and just mow through them, cutting them up into medium-sized chunks. Oops, I might have been a bit optimistic with that bowl. They're definitely not gonna fit in there. That's better. Before moving on to the chicken, I'll give the knife a quick sharpen. Chicken is slippery enough without having a blunt knife to contend with. And then I'll just add a board to my board to avoid cross-contamination and chop two decent-sized chicken breasts up into chunks. You could use thighs here instead if you prefer. They're more forgiving in dishes like this, but I didn't have them. Breasts will do fine. To cook this off, I'll just get a pan good and hot and add in some high smoke point oil. I'm using sunflower, and once it's shimmering, I'll toss in that chicken. Because I'm done with raw poultry now, I'll quickly wash the board, my knife and my hands, and then back at the pan, I'll start to move that chicken around and add in a good grip of salt at this point. I'll follow that with a few good twists of black pepper and then a quick stir around, and I'll let that chicken hang out over high heat to build a little bit of colour. This is looking great. I could go for more, but I'd risk overcooking the chicken and drying it out later on. If you went with thighs, then you could go for a little more colour here than I did, if you want to. Next, I'll sweat down my veggies, and I'm switching to a deeper pan now. Honestly, I could have used this to brown the chicken as well to save on washing up, but the silver pan looks better on camera. You do you. I'll set this over a medium-high heat to get things moving, and add a good squeeze of high smoke point oil. And then once it's got a bit of heat going, I'll throw in those onions and give them a stir to coat in the oil. I'll let those cook down for maybe a minute or two, and then I'll turn the heat down to low and add some butter. This is maybe 30 grams. I'll stir that in as it melts and then follow it immediately with the leeks and then a good grip of salt, maybe 10 grams. This seems like a lot, but we've got a lot of veg to season here. I'll stir that in and make sure everything is coated in that butter, and then I'll pop on a lid and just let that hang out over low heat for about 10 minutes until everything is sweated down and softened. 10-ish minutes later, I'll bump the heat back up to medium and add the chicken to the pan, being careful to get all the juices from the plate and stir everything together. Next, I'll go in with some plain or all-purpose flour, about 30 grams or an ounce, and just stir that through to combine, and then I'll turn the heat down again to medium and let that cook for a couple of minutes while I open this bottle of Nottinghamshire cider. This is a nice, fairly dry cider that's made just a few miles from where I live. Get something local to you if you can, and I'll just add 250 mls, or about half a pint of this, and give it another good stir to combine. The heat goes back up to high to give this a little bit of a kick start, and I'll keep stirring while it comes to a boil to prevent anything catching. My aim here is to get this up to temperature quickly to minimise the time the chicken is cooking to stop it drying out. Once it's up to a boil, I'll drop the heat back down to low and let it simmer uncovered for 5 minutes or so until thickened and slightly reduced. To that, I'll add 250 mls, again about half a pint of double cream, stirring constantly, and then I'll bump the heat back up for a minute or two to get that up to a low boil. As soon as it's bubbling, I'll drop the heat again. If we go too hard on this, there's a slight chance it will split, and we definitely don't want that. So I'll just keep stirring it and controlling the heat as I do until it comes to a gently bubbling boil. Once that happens, I'll drop the heat back down to low and leave it alone, uncovered, for 5 more minutes to thicken and reduce slightly. 5 minutes later, and this has a nice saucy consistency. It's leaving a trail when I stir it in the pan, but I want it to reduce a little bit further, so I'll give it a good stir and leave it again for a few minutes more. Just a few more minutes and this is looking perfect. It's still kind of soupy, but for pot pie, that's exactly what I'm after. I'll turn off the heat and everything is cooked now, so we're safe to check the seasoning. I've got the perfect level of salt, but the pepper needs a boost, so I'll grind in some more of that and stir it through, and that's done. I'll throw on a lid and let that sit and cool, ideally completely. Once the thing has cooled, it's time to assemble the pie. As mentioned, I'm using a block of store-bought pastry today. This is puff pastry. You can make this yourself. It's not especially difficult, but it's pretty time-consuming, and I just don't feel like it today. There's definitely a bit of diminishing returns at play with making this yourself. The final product won't be hugely different from the ready-made stuff, but if you want to make your own, by all means, go for it. So I'm just rolling this out on a lightly floured surface, and then I'll measure it against my pie dish and cut off the excess. Full disclosure, I made a silly mistake here and forgot that I'd need a bit of extra pastry to account for the fact that the filling wasn't going to fill my dish right to the top. Not overfilling the dishes by design, it'll go everywhere if you do, but spoiler alert, forgetting that extra bit of pastry does cause me problems later. If you're following along, just be sure to add an extra couple of inches each side when you cut the pastry. So, pastry cut, badly. I'll just roll that onto my pin and move it out of the way, and then I'll grab a bit of milk to use as glue for the pastry. The filling goes into my pie dish, and I'll just smooth it out to give an even covering. Next, I'll use a bit of that milk to glue the strips of excess pastry around the lip of the dish to give me something to stick the lid to, and then I'll bring in that lid and immediately realise my mistake when it doesn't fit. So I just faff around for a few minutes, trying to gently stretch it out and make it fit, in full knowledge that even if I make it work, it'll come apart again in the oven. If this were a fully enclosed short crust pie, this would be a disaster, and I'd just give up and make a new lid. But for a puff top pie like this, we can totally get away with it. It'll puff up just fine, and one of the best things about home cooking, in my opinion, is that it doesn't have to look absolutely perfect every time. The flavour is the thing that really matters. So once I've kind of made it fit, I'll just go around and finger crimp the edges. And you can see here, it's already starting to relax back before it even hits the oven. Then I'll brush on, or in my case, rub on, since I can't find a pastry brush, some milk for colour. And you could totally go with an egg wash here if you want, but I had the milk out already and it's good enough. And then that goes onto a baking tray and into the oven at 180C, 360F convection, 200C, 390F conventional for 45 minutes. 45 minutes later, I'll pull this from the oven and it's golden brown, fully puffed and bubbling slightly. And of course, it has a couple of big holes in it because of the mistake I made earlier. Even so, I totally got away with it. The pastry's puffed up perfectly and the whole thing's going to be delicious. So I don't even care about the holes. No, honestly, I don't. I'll let this cool for a few minutes and then I'll just cut the pastry into 6 portions and use a serving spoon to plate it up, being sure to get plenty of that filling as well. I decided to serve this with some parmentier potatoes today, video linked here and in the description, but this will go great with whatever veggies you decide to use. Give this one a try soon, folks. It's delicious, fresh, filling and perfect whatever the weather, and I'm sure you'll love it as much as I do. Thanks for watching the video, folks, and keep on cooking.